Amen. We want to use the opportunity to welcome each and every one of us to the Fresh Anointing Service. And it's a prayer that even as you are come this morning, your coming shall not be in vain. In the mighty name of Jesus. Please, let's listen to the following announcement. The January month of prayer and fasting continues. And I want to believe each and every one of us are fasting. And it's not enough to just fast. We need to pray also. So it's not going to be a weight loss regimen. Amen. Amen. So every day between the hours of 6:30 and 7:30, we gather here together to pray. And each day we have something we pray and we pray concerning every day. And we thank God for the testimonies we've been having so far. And my prayer and my belief is that yours is next in the mighty name of Jesus. And also, if you are interested in becoming a worker this year in the church, or if you are an old worker, you need to renew the workers, your commitment to the church. Application forms are still available at the church office. You can pick up the application form. You have to the deadline of 31st of January to turn them in. And also, the bookstore has an ongoing sale event until Wednesday, January the 25th. All purchases of $25 and above, we get a discount of $5. And I believe they accept cash, checks, and major credit cards. So please, I will encourage you to visit the bookstore today and be a blessing to yourself and also to somebody. And also, if you are born again and you are yet to be baptized by immersion, it's not an optional thing for you. We're starting a new baptismal class this Thursday, February the 2nd. So please, if you are yet to be baptized by immersion, you can pick up a registration form also with regards to that and turn it in to the church office. And I believe you shall be richly blessed. And also, the Daughters of Promise will be having a Valentine ball on February the 11th. So all single mothers are encouraged to please attend. And to the glory of God, two babies were delivered to us this past week. A baby boy to Mr. and Mrs. Kende Dosumu on Thursday, January the 19th. And also a baby girl to Mr. and Mrs. Akarewe, also on that same day. The babies, the moms, and the dads, I believe, are all doing very well. Praise the Lord. Amen. And on that note, I want to welcome each and every one of us to the first service, the Fresh Anointing Service. And I would love to acknowledge those who are fellowshipping with us for the first time. If today is your first time here at Jesus House, please could you rise to your feet? We'd love to acknowledge you. If you are fellowshipping with us for the first time, if today is your first time in this church, amen. God bless you, my sister. God bless you. Amen. Amen. Please, can you take another step of faith? Amen. Just take your bag and your Bible. Please come forward. God bless you. Dear sister, we just want to use the opportunity to welcome you to Jesus' house. Amen. We have, amen, amen. Amen. My sisters, we want to use the opportunity to welcome you to our midst. You are welcome to Jesus' house. Jesus' house is a mission of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. We are Pentecostal, a Bible-believing church. It's a home church. Amen. It's a church where everybody is somebody. Amen. And we want you to know that we're so excited to have wonderful people like you in our midst this morning. We do not take this for granted. We know you could have been in any other church or any other place. Somebody invited you and you honored the invitation. It's a prayer that God will honor you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Please, the reception card that was on the package that you were given, we need you to please fill them out for us. We'd love to keep in touch with you. And if you have any prayer requests, you can turn to the other side of the card, put in your prayer request, and we'll be joining our faith with yours. Once again, we want you to know that we love you and we appreciate your presence. And also, after the service, we're going to be having a brief reception for you. So please, we don't want you to leave in a hurry. Okay. And peradventure, you live in a neighborhood and you do not have a home church, Jesus House, what will you have them do? Amen. That's an open invitation we've given to you, so we'll be looking forward to seeing more of you. God bless you. Once again, please feel free. You're not a stranger. Amen? Amen. You are in the Jesus house, a house that belongs to Jesus, and Jesus indeed is your Father. So feel free in your Father's house. God bless you. Please, can you stretch forth your hands to the person to your left and to your right? Just welcome them to the presence of the Lord. Amen. Let them know how blessed they are to be sitting next to you.
Name, it's time to pray. It's time for our congregational prayer. Let's rise to our feet and call on Jesus. Amen. First of all, somebody is thanking God for a wedding yesterday. He's giving God the praise that everything went well. He's blessing the name of the Lord. Let's appreciate the Lord. Let's bless His holy name. Let's thank Him. Let's worship Him. Let's give Him the praise. And the person is believing God for Johnny Mercy, even after the wedding. Let's ask God that God will grant this person Johnny Mercy in the mighty name of Jesus. That God will just grant this person. God will make a way. God will go before this person with a pillar of cloud by day and fire by night. And the Spirit of God will lead this person. And the person will arrive safely in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. A couple of people are believing God for jobs. There are a whole lot of them that are believing God for jobs. And we are going to join our faith with theirs. Some people are believing God from temp to perm. Some are believing God for an opening, opportunity where they currently work. I want us to go before the Lord and ask the Lord that God will favor these people. That the Lord will open doors unto them in the mighty name of Jesus. That God will make a way for them concerning the job that they desire in the name of Jesus. That God will grant them the desires of their heart. Let's pray for favor. It is God that opens the door. It is God that grants job. Bible says promotion does not come from the east, west, or south. But God is the judge. He puts down one and He sets up another. That it is God that can put one up. Let's ask Him concerning every one of these people. The Lord will pay them a visit. The Lord will show Himself strong on their behalf. In the mighty name of Jesus, let's just commit them into the hands of the Lord. Father, we ask of you, O God, concerning every one of them, visit them. Let this week be their week. In the mighty name of Jesus, they will have series of offers. In the mighty name of Jesus, open doors unto them, O God. Let it be, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it be. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Somebody is believing God for his medical exam. He's believing God that God will it will come through in that exam. And a couple of other people are believing God for examination success. Let's commit them into the hands of the Lord. That God will give them wisdom. He will give them insight. He will give them angelic revelation. In the mighty name of Jesus, that they will excel in their exams. He will give them wisdom that will surpass their teachers. In the name of Jesus, that every one of them, they will come out victoriously. In Jesus' mighty name, every one of them, that they will excel. They will have every reason to testify. In the mighty name of Jesus, we ask this of you, O God, because you are the one that knoweth all things. Lord, help them. See them through these exams. Let them come out victoriously, giving you praise and thanks. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Somebody is believing God that the Lord will deliver her husband from alcohol. I want us to join our faith with this person. That the Lord will completely deliver this man. That yoke of alcohol will be broken in this man's life in the mighty name of Jesus. And the Lord will set this man free from alcohol in the mighty name of Jesus. We ask of you, O God, concerning this man, deliver him. We know that you can do this, O Lord. We break that yoke of alcohol over his life. Whatever is holding him bound, we command him to be released in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. We give you the praise, O God, because this is settled. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. A couple of people are believing God for the fruit of the womb. And some people are believing God for marriage. We're going to pray. We're going to join our faith with theirs in the mighty name of Jesus. Bible says it is Lord that caused there to be conception. Let's just ask the Lord that God will cause them to have conception. Now, they will not only have conception, they will carry the pregnancy till full term in the mighty name of Jesus. They will not cast their young. The Lord will visit them as he visited Anna in the mighty name of Jesus. Children are his heritage. Lord, visit everyone of them in Jesus' name. Cause them to have conception. Father, pay them a visit, oh God, in Jesus' name. Father, we ask this of you. Those believing God for marriage, Father, let them find the bone of their bone, the flesh of their flesh, in the name of Jesus. Cause their parts to meet in the name of Jesus. They will not miss it in Jesus' name. Visit them, oh Lord. We give you the praise and the glory. Blessed be your name, oh God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Finally, a couple of people are believing God for direction and protection. Let's ask the Lord. They're believing God that God will just show them the way, what to do, where to do it, when to do it, how to do it. Let's ask the Lord that God will grant them direction. Let's ask the Lord that God will reveal unto them what he will have them do. Let's just believe God for them. And if you are one of those, just believe God that today the Lord will open your eyes in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we ask this of you in Jesus' name. Supernatural direction, insight, in the name of Jesus. Open their eyes. Reveal unto them what you will have them do, oh God. Open their eyes that they may see the purpose you have for them this year. Thank you, Lord, for your protection. No evil shall befall them. As they go forth, you will go with them. Thank you, Father. We give you the praise. We give you the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. In Jesus' name, we pray. Let's be seated. Amen. I have a quick announcement about the prayer retreat. By the grace of God, the prayer retreat is this Friday, Saturday, in Jesus' name. I think we need to give God the praise. The first thing I want to say is that we already have about 400 people registered. And we are still believing God for more. If you have not registered, you still have an opportunity. And as many people that haven't paid their money, trust the Lord today, because we have to take all the forms over there today by the grace of God. We are already exceeding our room. We are already requesting for more rooms because we have already exceeded the quota that we give unto them. By the grace of God, it's going to be an awesome time in the presence of God. We are believing God that long-standing problems, we are demanding answers from the Lord, and the Lord will meet us in Jesus' name. For pregnant women, there's going to be provision for food. We will still be fasting, but the awaiting mothers and pregnant women, there will be provision for food. So let's just trust the Lord for that. And finally, people, if you feel that you really want to go and you cannot afford it, just see us, because we want you to go. We don't want you to have an excuse. Just see us. We can work something out. If you really want to go, it's nothing to be ashamed about. We are going there. We are going to call on Jesus. So don't be ashamed about anything. Just see us. And by the grace of God, the Lord will help us. We still have forms. If you need a form and you need to fill out the form, today is the day. If you have not filled it out and if you have not paid, you can see Deacon Tunde Okunbade. And the Lord bless you in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. As we pray, God will answer our prayers in Jesus' name. I am here on behalf of the Marriage Ministries of Jesus House. Hallelujah. And I'm here to announce the Valentine Ball for the married couples. Amen. It's going to be on Friday, February the 3rd. And the venue is the Martins Crosswind in Greenbelt. I'm sure you know where that one is. Do you know where it is? It's a very good place, right? And that's where we're going to. The topic for this particular program is sexual intimacy in marriage. Amen? See, there are some things that you will need wisdom to understand. Amen? You can pray and pray and God will answer your prayer, but some things you just require to sit down and think and listen, and then you'll have answers to them. Amen? When I said sexual intimacy in marriage, there was a pin drop silence. What is this man talking about? And some will be saying, I'm sure this pastor hasn't lost his anointing. No, he's still there. I've not lost it. Amen? But it's required in marriage. Let me let you know, it's required in marriage. I have found that in some marriages, sex is on demand. Do you know that thing in Comcast? It says, movies on demand. You have to demand for it before you get it, which is very, very wrong. Amen? Sex is supposed to be sex whenever. Amen? In marriage. The only clause that the Bible gave is, if both of you are fasting, or one of you is fasting, and it's by a consent that for this period, we will stay away from this. Amen? It sounds funny, right? But the truth is, marriages are breaking up, and when they go before a counselor or the pastor, they will tell the pastor, the reason why we're having a problem is because he doesn't respect me. He doesn't bring enough money. But the underlying thing is sex. But they will never say that. I mean, how will it be to go to the pastor? Pastor, we are fighting because we don't have enough sex or because we don't enjoy our sex. Pastor will say, what's wrong with these people? Everybody will want to bring in a different thing to hide the underlying issue. But that Friday, February the 3rd, we are inviting someone who has a PhD, a born-again Christian. All she does is help couples to achieve success in their marriage in the area of sex. And we are bringing him to come and talk to us couples so that we can understand what God wants us to do, particularly in the area of sex. And as you come, we are trusting that God will bless you in Jesus' name. It's in the Bible, so don't think he's going to be speaking from his mind. No, 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 he's going to be speaking from the Bible. And our eyes are going to be popping out and we'll see some of the things that God really wants us to do and to enjoy in our marriage. Now, we're only inviting couples, and the reason is very simple. We have the couples have the license and the liberty to do that. Now, I'm not saying the singles, well, you don't have the license or liberty, but are you doing it? I want you to answer that one to yourself. I'm not going to say you are doing it. And so, yes, answer that one by yourself, within yourself. But the truth is, you are not at liberty or license. And so that's why we're not inviting you. But believe me, very soon we'll invite you in Jesus' name. The price for this particular program is $90. Hear me out, per couple. The husband and the wife. It's going to include a lot of food. How many of us have been to, was in the last marriage retreat that we went to? I said, it's going to be a wonderful one. Some didn't believe me, but some believe and they went. And of course, they came back to thank me. And I'm telling you again, married couples, you will thank me and thank God after that weekend. Amen? The price is just $90 per couple. And for those of us who are complaining that we can't come because we have children, we don't know where to keep our children, I want to let you know we have made provisions for your children. Amen? We have made provisions for your children. The reason is because we know if you enjoy your marriage sexually, you will not have problem. Will you fight if you enjoy your wife? You can fight. That's a fact. And we want a solution by the whole couples in Jesus' house. We come to church with their spouses, holding hands and smiling. Amen? Praise the Lord. That's what we're looking for. That's the goal. And we will get there in Jesus' name. So if you're thinking, I can't come because of my children, it's a lame excuse. After the service, I want you to speak to Sister Bukio Olunuga. She will tell you and she will give you all the modalities. And we can only take from ages 1 and above. Amen? So if that is a problem, forget it. Speak to her. And on that Friday, you can drop off your children at the particular venue they gave to you. Amen? Praise the Lord. Again, it's $90. We have limited spaces. The spaces are going away so fast. We don't want you to miss out on this one. See Sister Mary with your registration, or Sister Buki Olunuga, or Sister Aladeshuru Tutu with $90. If you cannot pay $90 before then, just register with $45, at least between now and next Sunday, so we can tabulate how many people are coming and make provisions for the number of people. Amen? I trust you will register in Jesus' name.
Amen. We call on our dear sisters to minister to us in song.